Across the majority of the southern border between the states of Oregon and Washington is the major Columbia River, which separates the two by anywhere from 4,000 to 18,000 feet. However, there was a recent point in history where part of this river could be easily crossed on foot, as recorded in several stories and tales from indigenous peoples. As, sometime in the 15th century, a truly catastrophic landslide occurred on the north bank of the Columbia River, where 2.7 billion metric tons of rock collapsed all at once, completely damming the Columbia River. Known as the Bridge of the Gods, this natural earthen dam would remain for around 300 years, creating a 30-mile-long lake to its east. When the Lewis and Clark expedition traversed this area in 1805, they not only encountered a ghost forest containing thousands of dead trees killed by the backed-up water, but also a series of rapids from when this earthen dam eventually burst. When this dam burst in the mid-1700s, the Columbia River diverted a mile to the south where it remains today, and a toll bridge, also by the name Bridge of the Gods, remains in its place. I have overlaid the area that this landslide covers, totaling 6.8 square miles or 17.6 square kilometers and involving a cubic kilometer of debris. All of this mass detached as a single block of material from what is today Table Mountain, leaving behind a steep scarp in the landscape which remains to the present. However, looking around, we can see other large scarps in the landscape, indicating that other major landslides have occurred quite recently in the same area. In fact, this area contains 200 geologically recent landslides, of which 50 either moved or formed during the last 1,000 years. As an example, the Piper Road landslides, which I have outlined, formed in 2007 and began to move after heavy rainfall. So, why did all of these regional landslides occur? To answer this question, there is both a long-term and short-term answer. The long-term answer involves the nature of regional rock units. Here, you have a thick layer of hard and porous volcanic basalt from the extinct Columbia River flood basalts on top of a brittle clay layer. Both of these rock units are sloped to the south at an angle of several degrees, which on its own makes them fairly unstable to begin with. However, the area also receives heavy rainfall and snowfall, and especially after short or long-term periods of unusually heavy precipitation, water will seep into the porous basalt and end up pooling on top of the clay layer. If this groundwater reaches a sufficient volume, the amount of friction between the two layers will decrease to such an extent that a major landslide occurs. This is likely the primary reason behind why both the 1 cubic kilometer Bonneville landslide occurred in 1450 and the similar volume Red Bluffs landslide occurred around 1700. This leads to a potential more immediate cause for these two features. Those of you who are familiar with the area's geology probably have a light bulb going off in your head, as both of these dates are unusually close to when two Cascadia megathrust earthquakes occurred, ranging on the order of magnitude 8.0 to 9.3. These types of earthquakes occur about once every 500 years, where two such major quakes occurred in 1450 and 1700. Both major landslides and their margin of errors provide an overlap indicating that they may very well have been triggered by extreme ground movement from a major magnitude earthquake. Tales from native peoples seem to suggest that this was the case for at least one of the two major regional landslides, and this seemingly suggests that another major landslide could theoretically occur in the same area when the next megathrust earthquake strikes. However, correlation does not imply causation. While it is quite plausible that major earthquakes trigger these landslides, there is insufficient evidence to conclusively imply a definitive link between the two events. More landslides are likely to occur in the same general area in the future, but whether this occurs tomorrow, a century, a millennia, or tens of thousands of years from now is uncertain. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, E.L. Frederick, for supporting this channel.